Good morning, children. In the last class, we have completed up to 9th question in workbook. Today, let us do page number 86 in workbook, 10th question. Okay, children. Today, let us do 10th question in page number 86 workbook. Now, I am reading the question. How can you represent 7 parts out of 12 parts in a fraction form? Represent the fraction in pictorial and write whether the fractions formed is proper or improper fraction. So what we have to do, we have to represent 7 parts out of 12 parts in picture. So let us draw a square. Let us draw a square and divide it into 12 equal parts. Okay, children, we have to show the fraction 7 by 12 in pictorial form. So let us draw a square and divide it into 12 equal parts. So here I have divided the square into 12 equal parts. So the total number of parts is 12. Now I have to shade 7 parts. Now I have to shade 7 parts. So I have shaded 7 parts out of 12 parts. Here 7 by 12 is a proper fraction. Here 7 by 12 is a proper fraction. Why it is proper fraction? Because the numerator is smaller than the denominator. So it is a proper fraction. Did you understand the question, children? What we have to do? We have to represent 7 parts out of 12 parts by drawing a picture. So here I draw a picture of square and divided it into 12 equal parts, out of which I have shaded 7 parts. So 7 by 12 is a proper fraction because here the numerator is smaller than the denominator. So 7 by 12 is a proper fraction. Now let us do the 11th question. Now let us do the 11th question. Rohit divided an apple into 8 equal parts. He ate 5 pieces. He put the remaining 3 in the fridge. What fraction did Rohit eat? So how many parts did Rohit made his apple? Rohit had made his apple into 8 equal parts. So number of equal pieces apple is made. So how many parts did Rohit made? Rohit made 8 equal parts. So Rohit made his apple into 8 equal parts. So he have eaten 5 parts. So number of pieces 8. Number of pieces 8. So he ate 5 equal parts. Okay, children. Rohit took an apple. He had made it into 8 equal parts. And he have taken and he have eaten 5 parts. Now we have to show the fraction for this. So fraction of apple 8 is equal to fraction of apple 8 is equals to 5 by 8. Because he made the apple into 8 equal parts and ate 5 parts. So the fraction is 5 by 8. So he kept 3 parts in the fridge. So the fraction of apple kept in the fridge is equal to fraction of apple kept in the fridge. So he kept 3 parts in fridge. He kept 3 parts in the fridge. So the fraction is 3 by 8. He kept 3 parts out of 8 parts. So the fraction of apple kept in the fridge is 3 by 8. Did you understand, children? Rohit bought an apple, he cut it into 8 equal parts. In 8 equal parts, he ate 5 parts. Now we have to show the fraction of apple 8. So, out of 8 parts, he has eaten 5 parts. So, the fraction is 5 by 8. And he kept 3 parts in the fridge. Now we have to show the fraction of apple kept in the fridge. So, he kept 3 parts in the fridge. So, out of 8 parts, he kept 3 parts. So, the fraction is 3 by 8. Okay, children, now let us do the 12th sum.
Now let us do the 12th sum.
Two bottles contain the same number of candies. Rajiv took 3/4 candies from one bottle and Maya took 1/4 candies from another bottle. Who took more candies? So there are two bottles. In both the bottles, equal number of candies are kept. In it, Rajiv took 3/4 candies and Maya took 1/4 candies. So now we have to find out who has taken more number of candies. So first let us write down the fraction of candies took by Rajiv. Fraction of candies took by Rajiv. So how many candies he took? He took 3/4 part of candies from the bottle. So now let us write down the fraction of candies took by Maya. So Maya have took 1/4 part of candies from the bottle. So Maya took 1/4 part of the candies from the bottle. Now we have to find out who has taken more candies. So let us compare both the fractions. So 3/4 and 1/4. Here the denominators are same, so we have to compare the numerators. You all know it, that 3 is greater. So 3/4 is greater than 1/4, which means Rajiv took more number of candies. So Rajiv took more candies. Did you understand, children? There are two bottles. In both the bottles, same number of candies are kept. Out of which Rajiv took 3/4 part of candies and Maya took 1/4 part of the candies from the bottles. Now we have to find out who took more number of candies. So let us compare both the fractions. Here the numerators are same, so we have to compare the numerators. You all know that 3 is greater, so 3/4 is greater than 1/4. So Rajiv have took more number of candies. Okay, children. Now let us do the 13th question. I am reading the 13th question. Tank A can contain 13/18 liters of water and tank B can contain 15/18 liters of water. Which tank can contain more water? So here there are two tanks. And tank A can contain how much of water? It can contain 13/18 liters of water. Whereas tank B can contain 5/18 liters of water. Now we have to find out which tank can contain more quantity of water. Okay, children. So let us find out the which tank can hold more quantity of water. Okay, children. Fraction of water in tank A. So tank A can contain how much of water? It contains 13/18 liters of water. Now let us find out how much water can tank B can hold. Fraction of water in tank B. Okay, children. Tank B can hold 5/18 liters of water. Tank A can hold 13/18 liters of water and tank B can hold 5/18 liters of water. Now we have to find out which tank can hold more quantity of water. So let us compare both the fractions, 13/18 and 5/18. Here the denominators are same, so you have to compare the numerator. You all know that 13 is greater, so 13/18 is greater than 5/18, which means that tank A can contain more water. Tank A contains more water. Here we have to compare the fractions. Did you understand, children? There are two tanks. In tank A, there is 13 by 18 liters of water, and in tank B, there is 5 by 18 liters of water. Now we have to find out which tank can hold more quantity of water. For that, we have to compare both the fractions. Here the denominators are same, so we have to compare the numerator. You all know that 13 is greater than 5, so 13 by 18 is greater than 15 by 18, which means tank A contains more water. Okay, children. Now let us do the 14th sum. Okay, children. Now let us do the 14th sum. Now I am reading the 14th question. Ashish ordered bread. So Ashish had ordered some bread. 2 by 8 of the order includes brown bread. So he ordered 2 by 8 part of brown bread. Rahul also ordered bread. So Rahul and Ashish went to bread store, and Rahul had ordered 2 by 8 of the brown bread. So Ashish ordered 2 by 8 of the brown bread, and Rahul ordered 3 by 8 of the brown bread. So now we have to find out who has ordered more amount of brown bread. Okay, children. Now we have to find out who has ordered more amount of brown bread. Okay, children. So now let us do the sum. Fraction of bread ordered by Ashish. So Ashish ordered 2 by 8 fraction of bread. Okay, children. Fraction of bread ordered by Rahul. Fraction of bread ordered by Rahul. It is 3 by 8. Did you understand, children? Ashish and Rahul went to bakery, and Ashish had ordered 2 by 8 of brown bread, and Rahul had ordered 3 by 8 of brown bread. Now we have to find out who ordered more amount of bread. So let us compare the fractions. 2 by 8 and 3 by 8. Here the denominators are same, so we have to compare the numerators. You all know that 3 is greater than 2, which means 2 by 8 is less than 3 by 8. So what does it mean? It means that Rahul ordered greater fraction of brown bread. Okay, children, did you understand? Both Rahul and Ashish went to bakery, and Rahul had ordered 2 by 8 of brown bread, Ashish ordered 2 by 8 of brown bread, and Rahul had ordered 3 by 8 of brown bread. Now we have to find out who had ordered more amount of brown bread. For that, we have to compare both the fractions. So here 2 by 8 and 3 by 8. We have to compare these two fractions. Here the denominators are same, so we have to compare the numerators. You know that 2 is less than 3, which means the 2 by 8 is less than 3 by 8, which means Rahul had ordered greater fraction of brown bread. Did you understand, children? So this is the way of doing the questions. Okay, children? This is the way of doing the questions. Okay, children, did you understand? So I have done 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th and 14th questions. You all of you do the 15th question for homework. What the question is, Mohit cuts his pizza into 4 equal parts and Rahul cuts it into 16 parts. Rahul ate 4 pieces from his pizza. How many pizzas Mohit should eat as to equalize the quantity of Rahul ate? So here we have to find out how much amount of pizza should Mohit eat to equalize with Rahul. Okay children. Okay. You have to find out how much piece of bread should Mohit eat. How much piece of pizza should Mohit eat to equalize with Rahul. So you all of you do the 15th question for homework. Okay children, you all of you do the 15th question homework. That's all for today's class. Okay, bye.